Hey everybody, what's happening? Welcome back to another episode of C6 Garage, where I build junk to go into other junk. Anyways, I'm gonna try and start today off by installing the flywheel on that SBC400. I'd like to get the flywheel on, torqued into place. I'd like to get the clutch disc in place, pressure plate in place, I'd like to get the bell housing on, and some other goodies, and hopefully by the end of the episode, I will try and get it in this thing. I'm going to be doing it the lazy man's way and try and do it without taking the hood off. We'll see if everything goes good. I already got the transmission under the truck. I was going to make a video about it, but the automatic transmission came out pretty easily. Was really nothing exciting to watch me take it out, curse and swear. And I got the NV4500 underneath the truck. It's not in there, it's just underneath. I had bought a floor jack attachment for transmissions and I wanted to test it out and do a review on it, but it ended up being way too high and ended up just strapping it onto a regular floor jack and it's under there now. So I'm going to try and get the engine in by the end of this episode and hopefully next episode get the transmission in there. So should be interesting, should be fun. Might make a video tomorrow. I'm going on a road trip about 5 hours down the road. I found an LS3 dirt cheap. Gonna pick that up, gonna pick up my new car lift and a couple 350s along the way.
Things on the motor just to get it prepped to go in. I already put on the flywheel, I already put in the input shaft bearing. These are already been torqued on and Loctited. So next, I guess I'm gonna put on the clutch and the pressure plate, so we'll get into that. This is just a pretty basic clutch we got off Rock Auto dirt cheap. Pretty much supposed to go with the NV 45, so we'll see how that goes, but yeah, I'm really hoping everything just fits the way it should. Alrighty, now let's see what we got here. Put one bolt in just to hold it, I guess. Beautiful. Haha. Love it when a plan comes together. Alrighty. Got a couple of these started. I'm going to take them back out, Loctite them. Hopefully I have enough bolts. I just went to the shop to get a couple of these half-inch bolts, but no actual guarantee that I have enough to do this. Alrighty. One's in, so let's see. Three more, perfect. Loctite. Yeah. Hey, cousin.
Lunchtime.
Lunchtime.
Must be.
Oh. Well, I'm just gonna fire this thing on here, and yeah, I'll go get some lunch. Pretty, huh?
Pretty. Pretty nice.
You know what the best part is? It fits.
That is
the best thing. You know what else is a good thing? I have just enough bolts that I got from the shop.
Super.
I know. Just worked out perfectly. And after this, I'm going to fire on the bell housing. And then we're golden. Thank you. And then?
Come back for the rest of my meal.
All right, then. Have fun. So, Loctite it in place, nice and tidy, good to go. That's perfect, I like to see that. Alright, on to the next thing. Try and fire this bell housing on, I guess. That's bolted on there, so that shouldn't be going anywhere, but this old pile of crap, that can go. Shiny new. Look at that. Unfortunately, I was told we didn't have to wash anything. So normally I wash stuff, but in this particular instance, didn't happen. So, here's what it is. 1, 2, alrighty. Ugh. Oh yeah, that's right. Okay, fire these bell housing bolts in, and then, jeez, try and see if I can line this thing up to go in. It should be phenomenal, but no promises on that one. Yeah, it's pretty handy how this all just lines up. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the original bell housing off of 6.2 diesel. So, sorry guys, I think I got a chunk of steel in there, but whatever. Yeah, original bell housing off the 6.2 diesel. Same bolt pattern as a small block Chevy. That was one of the winning points that we did to put this whole project together. Didn't try to put it together on the cheap side, but I mean, you have to buy some things. We go.
All right, so got that new flywheel installed, got the pressure plate on, got the clutch in, got the bell housing on, put on the water pump. Hopefully we're good to go get this engine in this truck. Gonna try and get it in before the end of the day here, and then I'll call it quits and I'll come back with another episode. But yeah, gonna have at it right now.
All right, so we're gonna see how this goes. I'm really hoping to not have to take the hood off. There's a good fair chance I might have to. But anyways, we'll take it slow and see what happens. Hopefully it's just going to go in nice and easy. All right, a little bit ahead. Chances are I'm probably going to have to take the hood off, but last time it came out of here without that much trouble. So, let's see what'll happen. I wouldn't worry too much about that. All right. So, down a little bit, push a little bit. Gotta watch that shiny new engine paint job I just did. Okay, so looks like I'm gonna have room to do it, I hope. If I turn the engine this way, there we go. Just need to get it passed. All right. So I think what I might do is just there we go. Or not. Okay. Good, we're clearing. Alrighty, we're in. So, there we have it. We're in. Now, for this to work, I'm gonna have to lower and turn at the same time. Which is always the tricky part, but can be done. Just slowly lower it into place. Maybe I'll just get a good tilt on it here. Oh, I can't. That's unfortunate. Oh well. She's going regardless. There you go. Make sure I'm not stuck on any wires. Check this side for clearances. Should be okay because I tied back all the headers and stuff. Just want to make sure I'm not snagging on any wires, which I think I might be a little bit. But, oh yeah, not a big deal. Just the battery stuff. All right, let's try and get this bad boy in here and call it a day.
Gang, that's officially it for today. That's all the time I got to work on this thing. So next time I'm going to try and get the headers hooked up. I got to change out the passenger side header because it's kind of rotted out completely, but I got a new one over there. got to cut the hole in the floor for the transmission, then I'm going to jack the trans into place, get that all set up. I got to change a couple mufflers, and then once that's all done, we're going to get into all of the EFI and tuning and all that good stuff. So thanks for tuning in, and look for the next video. Take care, guys.